But hurry, because that minute's almost over. It's Fern and Kay.
The show where we ask 100 people a range of everyday questions. This week, we asked 100 bakers to name a type of bread. Now, unfortunately, it was on a need-to-know basis. Now, the aim of the game is very simple. Two families have to guess the top answers to the surveys we've carried out. Get them right, and they could win up to £30,000 for a charity of their choice. But get them wrong, and they'll hear this. Now we've got two families desperate not to look daft. Too late, they're already here. Hey, do you want to meet them? Yeah! Of course you do. Right, the head of our first family is the ladies' man from the Sharman family in Emmerdale. Yes, he's the Sharma Charmer. It's the one, the only, Chris Bisson! Good, thank you. How's yourself?
Very well, thanks.
Good. Chris, pleasure to have you on the show. Please introduce me to your family.
This is my sister, Laura.
Hi, Laura.
Hi, Vernon.
It's my sister, Nikwa.
Hi, Nikwa.
Hi, Vernon.
My brother, Kieran.
Hi, Kieran.
Hey, Vernon.
And my stepdad, Eamon.
Hi, Eamon.
Hello, Vernon.
Let's visit the home of the Willy Wonka of Emmerdale to check out his sweet family.
Hi, I'm Chris's brother Kieran, and this is our family hideaway in Cheshire. Come on in.
Chris once came home from school with his cheeks bulging with cabbage. He absolutely hated the stuff, but was scared of what the teacher would say if he didn't clean his plate.
Chris loves his hot pepper sauce. He literally pours it over everything.
We used to have a pet goat called Billy in our back garden in Manchester. But our big kid's world was turned upside down when his little kid went missing. He was really upset. Maybe he even went off in a Billy goat's huff.
Chris is a big Lionel Richie fan, but you might also find him breaking into song. He loves a bit of Diana Ross.
Caught in the middle of a chain reaction.
Chris's character Jay is Emmerdale's very own Willy Wonka.
And tonight we're hoping the sweet smell of success will rub off on us.
Come on, the mittens!
Very good. Chris, looks like you've got a tight family. Have you got what it takes to win Family Fortunes tonight?
Hopefully, yes.
All right, well, good luck. What charity are you playing for?
For Francis House, which is a children's hospice in Manchester.
All right, Chris and the Bissons, good luck. Give them a big round of applause. There's another posse backstage waiting to make off with the loot. Do you want to meet them?
Yeah!
Do you know what? I'm so glad you said yes, because it would have been really difficult if you'd have gone, no, do you know what? Can't be bothered, we'll just do it with the Bissons. The head of our next family is the drummer in Mcfly! They're screaming, let's bring him out, Harry Judd!
How are you?
Very good, thank you. How are you?
Very well, good to see you.
Looking dashing and handsome as ever.
Thank you.
Not many people get to say that about a drummer, but I'll say it. Welcome to the show, Harry. It's
thank you.
To have you with us. Please introduce me to your family.
Well, we have my girlfriend, Izzy.
Hi, Izzy.
Hi, Vernon.
And my mum, Emma.
Hi, Emma.
Hi, Vernon.
And my brother, Thomas.
Hi, Thomas.
And hi, Vernon.
Last, but definitely not least, my friend, Ben.
Why did they call him Big Ben?
It's pretty obvious, isn't it?
It is. Pretty obvious. Thomas?
Yes. Now, did you not get the memo that this is actually a primetime TV show?
Indeed.
And that it's going to be broadcast to millions of people?
Can I stop you there? That's my shirt before you...
before you... Let's look, Vernon.
What happened, Thomas?
I think the tie's a bit dodgy, to be honest.
Thomas, Thomas, look at you.
Good grief! Why did you bring him?
It's my shirt.
All right, it's time to up sticks and check out the family of our little drummer boy.
I'm looking up and boom, 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 bo
Hi, I'm Emma, Harry's mum, and this is his flat in London. So let's go and have a snoop around.
When Harry was a teenager, he kissed his first girlfriend for 15 minutes non-stop.
Harry owns more beauty products than me. He's got his own foundation and a makeup brush.
Harry is obsessively tidy. He always has an antibacterial wipe to hand, and he can't stand it when people don't use coasters. Oi!
Harry's childhood nicknames were Dinky
and Donkey. That's not my name. That's not my
Dinky, because he was quite small.
And Donkey, because he was stubborn as a mule.
E-R! Our rockstar Harry's favourite words are epic, classic, immense.
But it doesn't stop him singing along to the Moulin Rouge soundtrack.
Aww. Harry and the boys are used to topping the charts, so we're ready to find the top answers tonight.
The opposition will be juddering in their boots.
Come on, the Judd!
Just a word from the props department, Ben. Is there any chance we could have that inflatable doll back?
I took a liking to it, to be honest.
Yeah,
I did.
All right. Now, Harry, 15 minutes kissing the first girlfriend was all that.
Yes, way. Whoa. You know what it's like when you first kiss a girl. It's pretty exciting.
No, I
know.
No. Well, they ever held hands.
Can I hold my hand? All right.
Kiss. Stop it. No, you're all right. Harry, good luck tonight. It's all about charity. What charity are you playing for?
The charity is the Eyes Are Light Appeal, which my girlfriend Izzy set up, inspired by her brother Rupert, who suffered a severe brain injury. And the charity aims to make the dreams and wishes come true for people with brain injuries.
All right, so. Well, good luck. Let's hope, fingers crossed, that you can go home tonight with £30,000. Good luck, the Judds! We've got our families. I want a good, clean fight. No, I'm lying. I want a messy fight with lots of banter and lots of aggression. Good luck. Chris and Harry, come and join me. Let's play Family Fortunes. Chris, Harry, Chris. Now, Chris, got a quick picture of you as a young whippersnapper, right? Just take a look at this. That's you as a young lad playing the drums.
Yeah.
Right, now, we're opposite the drummer from Mcfly, a well-established, very, very successful rock band. All right, give him some tips, please. He's still not good at the drum.
Well, you're looking pretty good there, I thought.
Yeah, he looked natural, right, didn't he?
So wrong way round, though.
Oh, that's it.
Tip number one. Let's have a drum off. Give him a beat and see if he can replicate it.
I can't do that. I can't do it.
No, you're right. You can't.
That's why I gave up the drum kit.
Oh,
I can't do
it. Forget it.
Easy one. You ready? There you go, well done. All right, first question is signal money. Every point's worth a pound. We surveyed 100 people looking for the top six answers. That was terrible, Chris.
Hello.
Name a part of a woman's body that's usually larger than a man's. All right, go on, Harry.
Their chest.
I'll give you that. Their chest. Let's have a look. Our survey says... Yes, top answer, breasts. We'll play our pass.
I'm going to play.
Okay, let's go back to your family start conferring. You might get the chance to steal.
Okay.
Come on, Harry. Izzy, to you. Name a part of a woman's body that's usually larger than a man's.
Bottom.
A lot of ladies in the audience went, oh, care. Bottom. Let's have a look. Our survey says...
Yay.
Yes! Well done. Well done. Who's your friend? Emma.
I think hips, childbearing hips.
Childbearing hips, all right. You're saying hips, our survey says? Yes. Well done, Emma, you've won a spot prize. This prize is coming home with you tonight, Emma.
You'll have more than a wee smile on your face with this prize, Emma. Set on the bonnie banks of Loch Lomond, you'll be spending two nights at the stunning Cameron House. where you can play golf, be pampered in the hotel spa, or simply settle down and enjoy the breathtaking views. Achai the New.
Started.
Oh, fantastic!
Yeah, no, just started.
Oh,
getting,
good.
Getting
enjoy
good.
That. Yeah. Yeah, enjoy that. Get a little bit better, and I'll tell you what, that course, you will love it. So good luck. Well done, Emma.
Yeah,
Thomas.
Right, I think I might get in trouble, possibly, with the ladies, but I'm going to go thighs.
Thighs. Thighs. Name a part of a woman's body that's usually larger than a man's. So far, we've had breasts, bottom, hips. Thomas, you're saying thighs. Our survey says... It's not there. Unlucky. Big Ben, what do you reckon?
Right, I'm going to go with eyelashes.
Who's going to go with eyelashes?
I'm terribly sorry, Bernie.
Yeah. don't worry about it, Ben.
It's good, you're getting
I'm going to... In Chelsea, we say eyelashes. Yeah. All right, I'm looking for eyelashes. Our survey says... Oh, come on, unlucky. Harry. Now then, quite a critical point, huh? You've got one life left and looking for three answers. So you need to get an answer on the board to stay in the game, or the Bissons might get a chance to steal. What do you think, Harry?
I'm going to go lips.
You're going to go lips. Name a part of a woman's body that's usually larger than a man's to stay in the game. You're saying lips. Our survey says... Yes! Good job, Mo. Give me that. Izzy. Name a part of your body that's usually larger than Harry's.
Not your guns.
Oh, it's really tough, isn't it?
Name a part. Oh!
You got timed
out! You did run out of time! Unlucky, Izzy.
Oh,
unfortunately,
no.
I hate giving the third and final one when you've not even given me an answer. Unlucky. You're going to get one of these because you didn't give me an answer. Never mind. Oh, Eamon, what do you reckon?
Womb.
Yeah, Kieran?
I'm going to go for nails.
Nails?
Nails.
Nails, Laura?
Heart.
Chris?
Oh, you see, I was thinking nails as well, but I think women's hearts are bigger and they give more love, so I'm going to go for hearts.
Oh, you smoothie. Are you trying to impress?
Me mum and my missus.
Good lad.
Do you think?
Two most important women in your life, I'll be honest with you. All right, Chris, for the steal from the judge, let's have a look. We're looking for heart. Is it one of two of the missing answers? Our survey says... No! Okay, Chris, just quickly, lesson number one on family fortunes. Whatever you think is a big or clever or really impressive answer, forget about it. Just wind the window down and chuck it out.
I will do.
All right. Unlucky. Well done, the Judds! All right, well done. Well done. It was a tough board. Unlucky, the missus. Let's take a look at the sixth most popular answer. Hair.
We would have stolen it with hair.
Third most popular answer? Bread.
Bread.
Come on. Come on. Can't even drive.